let's talk about when you work with smaller lettering on an embroidery machine that has the automatic trim feature on, so it cuts it between every single jump. Now, if you look when you have smaller lettering, that means it's going to trim between the S and the U. I've got summertime is here on the screen. So it's going to stop, it's going to cut, and then move over. And sometimes on the back, you get a very messy look of the design because it's cutting. Those threads are being pulled to the back side. Both the top thread and the bobbin thread are trimmed, and then it starts again, and then those little tails are kind of locked into the next. And then because they're in such a small area, that doesn't look very good. So what you can do is when you touch go, you have an option for thread cut options. You can turn off that automatic thread cut for those trims and just go ahead and turn it off for your design. Now you can also turn it off in the settings. So I'll just put that hoop on so it's happy. Good. And then also too, by the way, if you are noticing it's going to stitch out all those steps or all why it looks like there's so many colors is remember turn the stop button off, and then what it'll do is it'll do all the colors and not stop between them. So that's the quick monochrome feature that also turned on when I touched that stop button. See how that's activated there? All right, you can also come in and to your settings, the default temporary embroidery settings. I think you can come in here as well and turn the thread cut option. So if you get halfway through your design and now you're at a place where you know there's going to be a lot of stops and starts, you can come in, turn it off, and then continue on. And then maybe turn it back on for the second part of your design. That really makes a difference in the speed of the machine as it stitches out. So let's just take a quick listen as it's starting to embroider. Oh, yes. By the way, there's a little message that's going to come up because it didn't cut it. It is going to stop and say, cut the thread. So don't be alarmed by that, but that's a little notation that you have activated or turned off the thread cutter. So let's just, like I said, listen and you're going to notice how quick it stitches and moves from letter to letter. So yes, we are going to have the little thread jumps that we can trim out the ones we can get our scissors under, skip the ones we can't get out, but look how much faster it is going to stitch out something with a lot of starts and stops. Now at this point, I might take the time to trim this long thread here. That way it is not caught while it's stitching the rest of these letters. So let's just go ahead and take a time, even just kind of swoop it out of our way and then let it continue. But now I don't have to worry about digging it out of the rest of those letters. I bet you think that was in record time, and that's because it was. So even though you have a little trimming to do at the end, I think it's worth it. Let's take a look at the back side. Isn't that so much neater on the back? I think the only thing that you would really want to do is trim this little jump thread. I'd cut it in half. Don't cut too close. Those little knots are holding everything together, and leave everything else attached.